Hello, everybody, and thanks for being patient. We had a couple of technical issues getting in here this afternoon. So if we are in fact live and you can hear and see me, go ahead and give us a thumbs up so that we know everything's working at your end. I'm going to go ahead and check it on my phone here, which means I've got to refresh it, which always takes a few seconds. And it looks like it worked. Yay! So we are live. All right, so let me go ahead and put this down because now I can know that you're there. So thanks everybody for joining us. And as always, when you come in, go ahead and say hello. Let us know where you're viewing from. And like I said, give us a thumbs up if everything is okay. At any time during the live stream here, if we don't have sound or something, go ahead and post that. And we try to read the comments so that way we can see if there's any technical issues, because today seems like it is the day for that to happen. So I'm glad you all came again. You saw me finish that little children's chair that we've been working on last week, so that's all done. I still need to go ahead and make a cushion for that, which I haven't done yet, but yeah, we're on. I checked it on Facebook. I can see it. I didn't know if I could hear it, but I could see it. So see if everybody, I'll look and see if we've gotten any comments on sound. Let's see. There's 13 of you out there I can see watching, but I don't see anybody saying that they can't hear.
So,
whoops, there
everybody.
We go. All right. Yep, the comments are starting to pop up, I see. So.
Can't hear any sound on
mine, it's
all.
Maybe it's muted, Bill. I don't know. So we always have some little malfunction, just that's the way the world goes. But I can see that you guys are starting to come in, and thanks for joining us. We've got a few of it. I can see the feed popping, so I know you're making comments. You saw the pictures of the fabrics that I posted that are going to be used for this project. And I did go ahead and get the deck started because it's just such a process. I didn't want it to take up time when we'd be bouncing back and forth from table to chair and table to chair. So we just figured it was easier for me to get that part done. I did post a picture of how I held the face fabric onto the frame of the chair or of the chaise and pinned in the pleats to get my deck to go around the skirt. So hopefully you saw that post. If you didn't, it's down in the feed. I think I posted it yesterday or the day before. So go ahead and take a peek at that, and you'll see exactly how I pinned this to the seat here of the chaise and got that accomplished. I'm going to flip it up so you can see underneath if I can get a hold of the fabric. But I've started attaching it. So this is the deck of the chaise, just like if you were doing a chair or a sofa. So I've gone ahead and I've stitched this face fabric all the way around the deck fabric where I needed it. And I pre-marked it so I knew when I was sewing it exactly where it went. And what I did was determine how far in from the edge of the frame I wanted that. And I did that all the way around. And I had the fabric pinned in place on the chaise when I did that to mark it out. And here in the front, you can see those pleats that I was referring to. And if you go back and look at that picture, you'll see them with the face side down and the pleats being pinned from the top. So you can see how that happened or how I did that. So I've got it right now just kind of hung on to here in place. I've pinned it and stapled it in the very center. But we do need to flip this up because I need to add some padding underneath the center. So let's go ahead and get that done. So I'm going to go ahead and flip this back. Being careful not to detach it where I've already pinned it on, and I can get my hand in there well enough to get padding in there. And I have also marked with a Sharpie on the deck itself so that I know where that area that I'm padding is, because it's not so important to get padded to the outside edges because that's going to be padded from the top once it's the deck fabric is attached to the frame. So let me go ahead and grab my cotton here. I'm just going to tear it down to size and then kind of trim it around the shape. Oops, and there's a little tear here, so let's just get that right off of there. And I'm just keeping it with inside my mark here that I made with my Sharpie. And I'm going to snug it right up there. And then trim it down on this side. So as you come in, go ahead and say hello. Let us know where you're viewing from. Let us know what upholstery projects you might be working on, if you're working on any. So here you can see, you're on the overhead camera, so here you can see that line that I drew. Hopefully you can see it enough. And then I'm just trimming this off all the way around it. And I'm going to put a couple layers on here. All right, is this piece big enough? I think it is, actually. So I can go ahead and put the second one right on top of it. Tear off these corners because they don't need to be quite so pointed. And I can feel with my hand so I know I'm getting it up nice and tight to where I've got that pinned. And actually, now that I think about it, this back section I do need to pad, so I'm going to add some more cotton in there because I stopped that decorative fabric just behind my arm post, so I will go ahead and pad this area in here. And I could do that by just adding in some pieces. Just tear off and put them in there, keeping them smooth. See, this probably won't go all the way around. Oh, maybe it will. So let's go ahead and do that. It will fit all the way around the edge. So I'm going to go ahead and tear it off. Had I thought before, I would have just left the back section big, but this will work just fine. Because I'm going around the curves, I'm going to need to do it in pieces. So this is just the base that's going to go underneath my cushion. So it's not so much for comfort in the end, because you are going to have a loose cushion on top of the chaise. Tear off that excess. And go ahead and pad that in there. Use up some of these little pieces, as long as I can make them all blend and feel nice together. That feels consistent. So now I'll go ahead and add another layer over that, because if you remember, there's two layers here in the center. So I know a lot of you have been excited about seeing this project come to life finally. It's been hanging in the background. I've had this chaise for quite a while. And I just haven't had a chance to do it. You know how that is. It's like you never get to your own stuff. Although Bill's telling me I should sell this. What do you guys think? Keep it or sell it? I'm thinking I like it. And keeping it would be fun. But it's like anything. If someone came along and offered me the right price for it, I might just say yes. Tuck this in there. Get that all held up there. So it looks like we've got quite the crowd joining us today. So I'm happy to see so many people here. If you could do me one favor while you're here watching, and go ahead and hit that share button on Facebook or YouTube, wherever you happen to be watching from, and share this with people that you know on your social medias. If you're from YouTube or if you're on Facebook, it just shares it on your personal timeline. Help other people to learn what we do here at Kim's Upholstery and to come join us for this fun project, because who doesn't want to see this one being done? All right, so that's feeling pretty good. This is beyond my arm, so I'm not going to... Although right there, I've got a little hollow. And maybe a smidge more over here. And if you feel with your hands, you usually can feel those low spots and fill them in. Okay, there's another little hollow back there. Let me grab some scrap cotton I've got hiding over here in the corner. Get all those little voided areas filled in, hey? So what projects are you all working on this week? We've got this that I'm doing with you guys today, but I also have two chairs that I'm working on. And it was funny because somebody in our members group the other day just posted that they had two chairs coming up that they were going to be doing for a client, and should they do them simultaneously or one at a time to keep the other as a reference. And my suggestion is always do them simultaneously so you know they look exactly the same, padded and everything when you're done. And that's exactly what I'm doing with these two chairs. So I'm just filling on these low spots. Sometimes you get low spots between the springs towards the edge, and that's what I'm working on right now. Let's just feel that a little bit more. That feels better. There. That feels pretty good. All right, get the rest of these little guys out of the way, and now I'm getting cotton flying around my nose. I can feel it tickling. Right, and that's plenty in the center there. So hello, let's see who's here watching today with us. We've got Monica, hello Monica, and Roxanne, and Sandra, and Debbie, and Kim, and Elaine. Thanks for joining us, ladies. We've got Kathy, and Lisa, and Lydia, and Lorinda, and Kevin. Sorry, Kevin, hi there, Kevin, Kevin's a guy. And Dari, and Joanne, and Brenda, and Lynn. Oh, wow, lots of you here today, this is really fun. And Rhonda, I think you were the one that was asking about the two chairs that I just mentioned. And Patty, and we've got Ada, and Cecilia, and I don't know if that's the same Debbie or another Debbie, and Carol, and Rhonda again, and Kelly. So hello everybody, and thanks for coming. And Gina, you just popped in. I saw you pop up just as I was getting ready to look away. So thanks for joining us, and again, go ahead and give us a thumbs up if you like what we do here at Kim's Upholstery, doing these lives. Share with your friends and family so that they know what's happening here, and let's get moving on this bright and colorful chaise lounge. So how many of you love the fabrics, and how many of you are like, okay, Kim, too much? Because I know it's really a taste thing. It's like you really have to like them. I fell in love with this plaid because originally I was just going to do the floral. And then I was like, I really want something for a contrast. So I was thinking, you know, maybe just a solid. And then I found this plaid and I'm like, I got to have it. And it was a discontinued fabric. So it's no longer available, and they had just enough left to do what I want, and maybe a pillow or two as well. So, all right. So now I have my center padded. We have not padded the outside area because we're going to go ahead and pull this down, and then we're going to put our edge roll on here. So what I'm going to do now is I want to get this pinned so that it's, I know it's centered on the piece, and I had drawn those lines that I showed you previously. So what I'm doing is I'm looking at the stitch line from my deck and lining it up with that line and getting it attached. I do have it pinned already in the front because I wanted that anchored before we started. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and just snug this where it needs to be. And I've got my container of upholsterer's pins, which sometimes get stuck and don't come out too well. So these are upholsterer's pins. They're not like anybody in the drapery world uses. And that's what I use to hold things down on the deck when I'm hand stitching something, or like in this particular instance, the way we're doing right now. So I'm going to go ahead and get that anchored all the way around. And I've matched my center with my center of my furniture in the front so that I keep that the way I wanted it, to keep my pleats in the right place. So is anybody working on any fun projects? The cotton is starting to like feather up my nose here. All right, almost there, a little bit further, pull. So what? Who doesn't want a chaise? Isn't a chaise like just a nice piece of furniture? It's something that everybody is always like looking at, and it seems like a lot of people are drawn to them. Okay, I'm gonna tear my cotton just a smidge here so I can get that back there. All right, now I am going to start working around the other side, and then we will go ahead and get this start to anchor it down. So now I'm coming over here and doing the same exact thing. I'm just curling the edge of the cotton underneath so that I can see where that line is. And before we anchor it, we'll go around and check to make sure it's all smooth. Just making sure I don't have any pins hiding up here. Nope. Okay. And I'm anchoring it right into the burlap. And I'm keeping it nice and taut from front to back, too, as I go. Hopefully not pulling it too far away from the front, and I've got it anchored well up there. Go ahead and separate that cotton a little bit, just like we did on the other side. Last one in there. Oops, I think I caught everything but what I wanted. There we go. All right. So now I am just going to flip this down, take one last look at it before we start attaching. So now you can see that center poofed up a little bit. Well, maybe you can't see it on the camera, but it gave it a nice little dome. And then when the sides are all padded, they'll be up a little bit higher than the center. So that's looking really good. And this is going to come under the back rail. Now originally I was going to actually sew fabric to the back here and have that plaid come in from here, but then I decided to do it a little bit different because I decided with the inside back, I'm actually going to sew a piece to the bottom of the inside back that will end up being my finished piece on the outside here. So. Yeah, so that looks good to me. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and get some staples in there. So I'm going to go ahead and get some staples on the back end first, because I've got the front with one staple already up there. So I'm going to get some in the center of the back. Just making sure that all feels nice. I want to make sure I keep it nice and tight, too. In fact, that was another conversation we were having in the private members group as people were talking about how tight do you have to pull stuff. And sometimes you really are pulling it a lot tighter than you think you need to, but you really do need it tight. All right. So like I said, I already have one staple here in the center of the front. So I'm going to go ahead and work this way a little bit. I've got it all stapled where, or pinned down where I want it in here, so hopefully I'm not shifting it too much. And left to right, I'm just going more snug than really tight, but front to back, I wanted to really get that anchored. All right, now go to the other side. And all of this will be padded afterwards. Oops, looks like something's poking up. Yep, I got a random staple. Let me go get some pullers. It's important to always get those out when you find them, because if you forget and don't take them out, somebody will feel them in their bum later. So have any of you ever done any chaises? Upholstered any? All right, let's pull it down and look at it one more time. That's getting tight. And then when I do this, okay, that's looking really good. All right. Now I'm going to need to make the cuts to get around my arm posts. Those fun, scary cuts. And we actually did a little video of the cuts on this lounge, chaise lounge for our member site. It's not done yet, we just filmed it. So you'll have the cuts on that too as well. Scissors, Kim, what did you do with your scissors? I don't know, but here's another pair. All right. So I'm gonna go ahead and mark this just because of the angle I'm at. And trying to cut. Oops, almost dropped my chalk. Oops, the second one didn't mark. Okay. Yep, that is it. So much cotton in the way, I wasn't sure. Now, this is not the cut you'll use in your finished fabric, but for what I'm doing right now, this is all I need to do. Get my fingers stuck in between the spring and the frame there. All right. And then I gotta get around the back post here. We just got a new scissor sharpener too, so all my scissors are fairly sharp now, which is nice. I didn't realize what bad shape my scissors were in until Bill sharpened them all with this new tool we got. I tell you, what a difference. All right, so that side is ready to attach. Looking good. Those two staples for now. Looks like that cut needs to be a smidge deeper. Sometimes it's awkward to get the angle you need to hang on to stuff. I think that upholstery is another form of yoga. It's like you contour your body. So there, now that's looking pretty good. So you can see from the back here. Get just a couple staples to hold it, and I'll go make the cuts on the other side. And then this is coming down. And I'll go ahead and do the same thing on this arm post. And I'm just making myself the chalk marks for reference. Oops. Come on, scissors. Tuck my tail. Try not to get tangled in my hose, which happens. All right. Keep you up in there patting. Okay, that one needs to be cut a little deeper. And that side as well. If you got a wrinkle, chances are it's going to be deeper. And that spring is right up close to the wood, so every time I stick my hand in there, I catch it on the spring too, which doesn't feel that good. Whoops! It helps if your staple goes into wood. Cotton up off the edge. All right, now this one. So it probably took me, even though this part seems to be going pretty quickly, when I was figuring out the pleats and everything, that really did take me a little bit of time. It probably took me about an hour to get that all figured and ready to go. But while I'm looking at you, thanks for everybody that shared. Bill, just let me know that a lot of you shared. So thank you very much for doing that. We appreciate that. And I don't know how many of you read our blog post that we have purchased this building that we are in. So it is the home of Kim's Upholstery for indefinitely. I said forever home, but you know how you say forever, and forever doesn't always mean forever, because who knows, maybe we'll end up needing a bigger space someday. But I think this is probably going to be the forever home. I'm just getting the cut to get around that post. There. Tuck my tail. Alright, now come back around here and get those attached. That's the other thing with upholstery. I don't know about you guys, but you're always up and down and up and down. In there, that looks really nice. It's really nice when your cuts come out just so perfect that everything looks awesome the first time. Oops, that one seemed to go into the air. There we go. Go finish around this way. So I do have some chalk lines and stuff on here that we'll brush off when I'm done. But from when I was marking stuff earlier. All right. So earlier today when I was working on those chairs, I was like, had everything ready. I was gripping it the way I needed to grip it. Got it all into position, and then before I knew it, I ran out of staples. So then I was like starting over. It's like you had to let go fill your gun with staples, and then come back. Don't you hate it when that happens? It's like sewing and having, which camera am I on, Bill? I can't tell. I don't know who I'm talking to here. I've got four cameras set up today. This one, okay. So Bill's putting me at this camera because I'm looking, I'm like, he's looking at something different, so I couldn't tell where you guys were when I was talking. But yeah, so I had everything held in place, went to put that staple in after I'd concentrated and got it and realized I was out of staple. So it's kind of like sewing something and you've sewn about 20 inches and you find out you haven't had any bobbin thread. So it's that kind of thing. So then I had to get my gun filled, re-grip everything, get everything into position all over again. And of course, it's always more difficult the second time just because, right? All right, so now I'm going to go ahead and pop all these pins out. Check one more time for the fit, make sure nothing shifted on me. Although, let's check it before I pop the pins out, just in case. Not that I think I'm going to have to change anything, but Murphy might think different, so. Yeah, so once my edge roll's in there, right now it doesn't look pretty neat, but it will. This, what I'm looking at is just the deck area, making sure that looks all nice. Okay. So now I'm going to go ahead and pop all these pins out, and we will add our edge roll, and then pad in these other areas. Because if I don't take the pins out now, I'll get going along and forget. It's kind of like you have to do things in a certain order the way you do them all the time, because if you mess up with your order, you forget some little thing that's minute, but then in the end could be major. All right, dropped one pin. Where'd I leave my bucket? Yeah, you have to have a set of upholsterer's pins. Upholsterer's pins and regulators are like two of those things that you use for every single project you work on. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and get a couple more staples in different spots here, and then we'll get the edge roll going. Thank you. don't need a ton more staples because I am putting Edgerol right on top of this, but okay, there's my Edgerol underneath my chaise. So I'm going to go ahead and start attaching, and I had it temporarily hitched here before, so that's why I got a couple staples here when I was getting that part pleated in the front there. Whoops. So Marfisa says, will this be available to watch later? I have to leave now. Yes, these are all recorded as we do live, so you will, I don't know where you're watching from, if you're on Facebook or if you're on YouTube, but you will be able to watch this later. So just go through the feed if you're on Facebook and you'll find it. And if you're on YouTube, just look for episode 37. So enjoy the rest of your day and thanks for coming this morning. Getting them started sometimes is the hardest part. And I've got some areas where the springs are right up tight against me, which is okay. Get it in position. There. And this stuff, I tell you, it comes coiled, but then when you try to uncoil it, it fights you laying down straight sometimes. So I'm just attaching it right to the top of that rail, the top of the bottom rail, and the bottom of the top rail, no, top of the bottom rail, which is basically your frame for your seat area. All right, so right here, it's a little bit higher. Bill, could you grab me the next size down of Edgerol? I think I'm going to piece it in because that post from the leg, it's sticking up a little bit higher than I thought it would be. So I will use a little bit smaller edge roll over those areas. So we'll end up having, what, 3 pieces of edge roll here. Thank you. So go ahead and cut this off. And this is a handy tool. One of the students in one of my workshops introduced me to this tool. I've had 2 really great tools be introduced to me from students in workshops. This is, I forget what they call it. It's just a square knife, I think is what they call it. But it's a, where's the camera here? It's a C.S. Osborne tool. And it just is for cutting stuff like this. And it works awesome on cutting this edge roll. And then the other tool I was introduced to by a student is a tucking tool from Osborne, which I'll grab and show you that after. That is an awesome tool as well. And actually, if any of you out there are going to CWC and taking my classes, you have a chance to win a tucking tool because Rolly was very generous and donated a couple tools for me to raffle off. Or not raffle off, but give as door prizes. So Gina says, why did you not hand sew the deck area to the springs before attaching like you have done on chairs, decks previous? The way this is all attached, it's not necessary. You could still do it if you want, but everything is held in place so that you really don't need to. But like I said, if you wanted to, you could definitely do that. So anyway, so what I was saying, yes, is Rolly Company has donated some tucking tools for me to give to students that are taking the class. So if you're in my class, you might win one. So bring your business cards for a drawing. I ran out of staples here. Here's one of those random staples from before.
Looks like the way you're doing it now, it's going to allow you to raise up the outer edge of this too and keep the center down.
Right, yeah. My center will be a little bit lower than the outer edge this way. What was I looking for? Pullers. OK, Okay, you little bugger. Come on out of there. There we go. Yeah, so it will all make sense in the end when we get to that part of the deck. And the previous, we tore this apart, I don't know how many years ago, Bill, do you remember? A lot of years ago.
Probably 2 years ago.
2 years ago? Thought it was even more than that, but 2 years ago he tore this baby down for me, and I'm finally getting to it. I'm sure you can hear him. I have all these projects. I'm like, oh, I want to do that. Will you tear that down? He's like, no, you get enough of a pile growing already. So it sat here for 2 years. So that's, he's saying that's why he's not in any hurry to tear my stuff down. I'm coming from the bottom just so I don't cut my deck, because it would not be good to cut it at that point. Probably should have left one more staple out. There we go. All right, and then these little spots that are over the top of the leg. So what it is this leg has a square post at the top that sticks up. About a half inch maybe, and I'm going to use that smaller edge roll over those areas just to bring it all up to the same height and not have that bump up, which is just apt to make your life a little more difficult, that's all. So when we get back from CWC, which we'll be headed out to Tennessee to teach at that conference on the 30th of April, so not too, what is it, 2 weeks away, less than 2 weeks away? When we get back from that, I'm just going to give this a tug, make sure I have it attached enough everywhere. Yeah, can use a couple more staples up here. Dance with my hose here. Dandy cutting tool. this last part I can cut with the scissors because it's just the lip. And then cut the second one. Even though this tool doesn't look like it would be that sharp, it really is sharp, so you gotta be careful with them. You don't need to be taking any fingers off. There. Stick this under there for now. And there, now I've got two perfect little pieces, and where did the second one go? There it is. To hitch right in there. And that gives me the perfect height that I needed. So that's exactly what I needed size-wise. Look at that. Just like a nice smooth transition. So go ahead and attach those. There, perfect. All right, so we are now ready to pad it. Set this down over here. So I'm gonna go ahead and fill the low spots in with cotton, and then we'll start leveling it off. And let's just do one last test fit. And I also need to trim that decking fabric back, but yeah, you can see that's gonna go over there really nicely. All right, cotton. Time for cotton. And these are the areas, too, where all those little pieces you collect of small scraps of cotton you can use to fill in these little tiny low spots first to bring them up even with the height of the springs and the edge roll. So it looks like it's rolling forward just a smidge. I'm just filling in the void between the springs and the edge roll. So we don't want any hollow spots. So I'm thinking this might go in my bedroom. We'll see. We'll see what Bill says. Here you could use a little more, and you really can just like feel the difference if you really pay attention to what your hands are doing and not what your eyes are seeing. So I'm just wedging it right in there. And it'll end up looking much smoother in the end if you take the time to do this. Yeah, but you can see that this isn't going anywhere. So really, taking the time to sew that down would have been an extra step that I really didn't need to do because it's not shifting at all. So let's go ahead and get some more cotton before I tear off. Are there any more scraps? I don't think so. A little bit more up here. Holy smoke, I just looked at the clock. We're getting close to the 1:30 mark already. Time really does fly. I was just talking about that with somebody else. And then somebody in the group, I think it was Heather, actually posted a comment about she has no concept of time because the way things go in a daily basis. And I understand that. Because it's like you feel like you've been working for like a quick time and before you know it, an hour or more has gone by. It's like sometimes I look at the clock and it's 4:30 and it's like I've been here all day and I didn't even realize it. All right, so now I'm liking the way all that is feeling. So So we are going to go ahead and I'm going to trim off this excess of the deck, and then we're going to pad the rest of this with the cotton. Just follow right along there. Thought that was a staple, but it was fuzz. This is a pretty chaise. I like the style of this. You could give it a really shabby chic country feel, or could have gone with a toile and been a real French country. But this is my version of funky country. I like country, but I like country with a lot of color. Like, I don't know if you've ever seen, you probably saw the wingback chair slip cover I did quite a while back that was a bright yellow that the woman had made the fabric on Spoonflower. Kristen Nicholas is her name, and her house is awesome. It is like so full of color. It's, you walk in and you can't help but smile. And if I sat here and listed all the colors that even showed you swatches, you would say, oh my God, that house must be a nightmare. It must not work. But oh, it is beautiful. It works perfect. In fact, she has a thing on Howes where she has a video of a tour that Howes did. They came out and did a video of her property and her house, and some people on Howes were even like, that's way too much color for me. But when you're in her house, it is such a happy space. There, one more piece of trim. It's like rules with this kind of stuff are made to be broken, right? It's got to be, the end user has to like it. It doesn't have to fit into any design guidelines. So, and I see one spot where I need one more staple. Now that I've trimmed it down, I can tell. And I need to dry my hair with my staple gun. A couple more over here. It's one of those things, once you start filling in, you see more spots. You've had that happen, I'm sure. All right, so now I am ready to go ahead and start adding cotton. So keeping all this in the center. And it'll probably need two layers of cotton, I'm guessing maybe three. And I don't measure my pieces, I just kind of tear off strips. So here I've torn off a couple pieces to get me going. Go ahead and put them up against each other nicely so that they don't cause a lump. And here where I've got to go around the corner, actually tear that off. If I tried to force it around the corner, I probably would have ended up with too much bulk in one spot. There. Go around this other side here. So you get a bird's eye view when you're on that camera, huh? Oops. So I'm just feathering the ends of the cotton together so I don't have any sharp edges that you can feel between the two strips of cotton. And then a little bit more at this end, and then we'll go over it with another layer. I think I am going to do a third layer. Tear off a couple more pieces. Oops, that one I think I tore a little bit wide, but that's okay. We'll use it. I try not to have my joints all land on top of each other, but sometimes you can't help it. Go ahead and stagger this way. And this should do it for the second layer. Now, for those of you who are members, if you remember, we will be live in the group today at 3 o'clock answering your questions in our Wednesday Q&A. I've got a few questions compiled from the group, but there weren't too many this week. So we'll go live at 3 and we'll stay live as long as we have questions. And again, we're going to be using that BlueJeans platform, and that is the platform where you can come in live with us. So I hope some more of you will come in this week. We've had a couple come in and try it out, and it's kind of fun because you really get to have a real conversation face to face, not just typing back and forth.
I don't know how that works. They have to accept it.
So yeah. So Bill will post a link in the members group for people to join in the conversation. So you'll see us live in the group on Facebook. So you'll actually see us on camera, but then he will post a separate link, and you need to click on that link, and that will bring you into the BlueJeans platform. So it'll take you off of Facebook, and you will need to accept it. And then once you accept it, you have to turn on your camera and turn on your mic so that we can see and hear you. If you choose just to turn on your mic and talk and not be seen, you have that option too. But of course, we'd love to have you join us and be able to see you. And then when you do that, we ask that you mute your Facebook portion, because otherwise you get an echo because you'll hear both feeds. And there is a little bit of a delay that you see when you're in both rooms at the same time that you don't see if you're not.
The nice thing about this is if you're on an iPad or your iPhone and you're working on a project, you can actually take your camera over and show us what you're doing.
Right, so you can come into BlueJeans on your cell phone or your iPad, and then as you're on there, you can have it aimed at you. But if you want to show us a specific area in your project, you just hit the button that turns your camera around, and then you can walk over it and you can actually show us what your specific question is. So that's really a great feature with this. If any of you were watching us back when we did Blab, it's very similar to that as far as the functionality of it, but it's not its own website like Blab was. So we hope some of you will come in live with us today. And that's feeling really good, but I still think I want one more layer because I just want that soft little curl at the edge. Go ahead and tear that off. I think it took about 3 or 4 pieces. Whoops. And I'm going to deliberately stagger this one this time. All right, and this time I'm going to go over the edge just a hair. So next week when we come back, we will be starting on the inside back, or I'm sorry, the outside back will be the first thing we do next week is put that fabric on, because this outside back gets upholstered from the interior, and there is no surface staples on the outside of the back. There is for the arms, but the back there is not. So next week when we come on, we'll start with the inside back. Well, actually, we'll finish this deck and start with the inside back. And then we'll start with outside back, and then we'll start with the inside back. Okay, so it's just curling over that just a little bit. Wait, one more piece, maybe two. Can this do the full distance? Yes, it can. Yay. There. All right, now I'm going to go around the edge and staple the outside edge of this cotton down a little bit while I say goodbye to you. And then I think I will get this started stapling in a few places, and then we'll come back next week and we will finish the deck together. And like I said, we will start the outside back. So thanks again for taking time out of your busy schedule and joining us here live on Facebook and YouTube. We appreciate you coming and joining us. And those of you that are members or have taken my workshops, we'll see you this afternoon at 3 o'clock in the group. So thanks everybody, and have a wonderful, colorful day.